So, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Sitting on a porch, it's fucking freezing out here, minus 15. Sitting here with Vres and myself.
We started out doing the new album in the spring with going to Trollhorn's place, getting together with riffs, gathering riffs,
getting drunk,
going sauna. And here we are. Half a year later with the finished product. The process this time of making the album was quite the same as actually the last album. Henry doing demo versions of all the riffs we gathered.
Went again to his place, went to sauna, got drunk.
Recording was made in 6 weeks altogether with the mixing. We were running out of time because it was supposed to also be on the weekends, but we were away.
And then we decided to go on festivals and play a show.
Needed some money also.
Yeah.
So we actually really concentrated on getting a nice production this time.
Yeah.
With going as far as you could go with the sounds. And actually this time we concentrated more on the guitars than the album before.
Yeah, like any album before.
Yeah, really removed a lot of keyboard pads, strings, just to make room for guitars. Lots of acoustic instruments on this one also, with friends coming over to play. With real violin, we have a friend from Iran doing some percussion.
Percussion, yeah.
We had real mandolins, real banjos, real strange acoustic guitars from Bulgaria. The thing was, we have done this like drunken boys choir all the time, but this time it actually turned out that we're doing like harmonics,
doing
big ass choirs all the time, and we're doing them by ourselves, not
like
putting them on keyboards.
Funniest moment on recording, this is like we're doing backing vocals, and all of a sudden Trollhorn realizes who's singing, who goes that high, and then, you know, we realized that Samu can actually do proper, like...
Beast Dominator is going...
No, sorry, Beast Dominator can do like a really, really high, what's that, like...
falsetto.
Power metal falsetto.
This album we used Katla again for the lyrics, and this time there it's not a concept album in that way. It's different stories for different songs. It's they're all like different myths, legends, and they're like legends that repeat themselves all over the world.
Yeah, like they've been around for ages and ages. They just have different characters and different names, but basically the same stories.
I think the idea of the photos came up like 1.5 years ago. We were just sitting around, then
playing cards,
drinking red wine, and we started developing different characters we decided why not do this, because we have done actually a little bit fed up with the concept
of gold forest and be all trolls and it's like everybody does that nowadays,
and we wanted to do something really different, something that makes us stand out, and actually something that looks really cool. We went in the line of like Carnival from Hell slash like steampunk
slash like gypsy camp from hell. So the tours we're doing
we're starting in mid-February,
3.5 weeks European tour, and after that is American tour. It's all finished lineup. It's gonna be hellish.
It's gonna be
with Moon Sorrow and Swallowed Sun and
Survivor Zero.
Definitely worth the coming, as we see.
The new album will be out in mid-February all over the world through Century Media.
And it's called Niflheim.